African armyworm is a major crop pest throughout the whole of sub-Saharan Africa, but particularly on the eastern side of the continent.
It's December 21st, everyone's getting ready for Christmas, and I'm on my way to the airport to catch a flight to Zambia to assess the food security crisis caused by armyworms.
I'm at Manchester Airport, I'm on my way to Zambia. I've got a busy couple of days ahead of me. What I'm hoping to do is to visit some farmers who've been affected by armyworm, assess the impact on food security. I'm going to collect some armyworm samples to take back to the UK for analysis. And if all goes to plan, I hope to meet with the Vice President of the country to discuss the armyworm situation and what can be done about it going forward and the role that biopesticides might play in the future.
We had a lot of them. Just anywhere you see them.
The armyworm.
Yeah, the armyworms.
So Donald, tell us about this area.
Basically, this whole land was green, but the outbreak of these armyworms, basically, they are amazing grazers, and they've turned the whole land, which was green, to almost bare, which is now the way it is looking now. If you had come 4 or 5 days ago, when it was all green, really they were, like, all the leaves are just covered by these armyworms. Yeah.
This is what the crop should look like. Next door, however, it's not so good.
African armyworm is subject to a number of different parasites, including parasitic wasps, fungi, and importantly from our point of view, a baculovirus, SPEX-MPV. Now, what we wanted to do during the BBSRC funded project was to try to understand what levels of virus we see in the natural environment, in the natural outbreaks of armyworms, how variable that was, to try to understand why it was variable, and importantly, how we can use that variation in the incidence of virus disease to better target our control efforts against armyworms using SPEX-MPV as a biological control agent. So we're now at a point where we have the capacity to produce SPEX-MPV in large amounts, and we can do that in Africa itself. We now have a processing plant for doing that processing of the dead caterpillars that we have. This is a new processing plant that's been built in Arusha. It's run by Crop Biosciences, and the building was funded by the Department for International Development. So we feel that if we can get that, produce sufficient virus that we can control and target those source populations in Kenya and Tanzania, we can have a significant impact on the development of those outbreaks and stop further outbreaks, not only in Kenya and Tanzania, but also in those neighbouring countries.